This is Reaper, and it's my secret weapon in the battle for quality voiceovers. And today I'm going to show you the ultimate setup and workflow that I use every single day. And stick around till the end for a bonus that it took me a while to even find out about. Every DAW claims to be the best, and for me it was always a struggle to get used to their way of doing things, until I discovered Reaper. I'm Richard, and I am your voice actor. So first of all, this video is not sponsored by Reaper. Reach out if you want to, Mr. Reaper. Reach out. Let's take a look at Reaper. Reaper is a DAW, or digital audio workstation, with a MIDI sequencer and video editing. More about that later. And it's the flagship product from Kokos, whose founder, Justin Frankel, was famously one of the original developers of the infamous Winamp Media Player. It's available for Windows and Mac and Linux, and I quote, "You get 60 days of evaluation free with full functionality and no strings attached." Do be aware that the evaluation period is 60 days, after which you should pay for it. So if you get a message like this, it really is time to pay up, mate. 1,678 days is 5.5 years, and that's technically stealing.
You wouldn't steal a handbag.
And come on, it's only $60. Honestly, it's a steal for what it offers. It's got to be the most affordable, the most versatile, the most flexible, the most feature-packed DAW there is. And at this point, I want to give a quick shout out to two amazing video creators. The softly spoken Mike Del Gordio, aka Booth Junkie, without whom I probably wouldn't have discovered Reaper in the first place, and the inimitable and equally softly spoken Kenny Joya at Reaper Mania, without whom I almost definitely wouldn't have figured out half of the stuff I'm about to show you. And with that said, let's get on to the setup. Now it's definitely worth taking the time to set everything up exactly as you want it, because then you won't ever have to do it again. And when I first started using Reaper, I had a pretty good idea of exactly what I wanted it to do. And I've split this into two parts, the basics and the customization. Let's start with the basics. In a nutshell, I wanted to be able to use my Steinberg UR44 interface to put one mic into Reaper, which you can set up in preferences, have one track for recording voice. I also changed the ruler from BPM to time and added a spectrogram and pre-FX volume for more editing control, and have an FX change just for voiceover. I have a dynamics processor in case there's any unwanted noise from somewhere, a D-click for those noisy mouth days, and a light compressor and limiter, and a loudness meter, although I actually very rarely use any of them. Plus, I have a high-pass filter on the input, just in case the washing machine is on. I also have a couple of things on the master meter, which I have at the side here. You can move that to wherever you want to. I have mono selected, as the majority of what I record is voiceover that needs to go out in mono. I have a limiter set to -3 dB, although it never actually reaches that. And I have a Julian loudness meter. That's for the clients who need to know luffs. I wouldn't worry about it too much unless you do audio for broadcast or very high quality streaming. And in the dock at the bottom, I also have my video window, more about that in a moment, and a big clock. And on the other side, the mixer. And that's it. I save that as a template, and every time I open Reaper, it opens exactly the same and everything is there ready for me to go. Okay, now that we've got the essential setup, let's take this one step further and customize Reaper to work even harder. Okay, so I wanted Reaper to do a couple of things that I wasn't really sure it would be able to do. This is where Reaper really comes into its own with this incredible customization. Okay, first up, I am terrible at naming and saving projects before I actually start recording. So I wanted a way of reminding myself to do that every time I opened Reaper. So every time I open Reaper, the dialogue now opens automatically and I'm prompted to name the project and save it before I even begin recording. The second thing is I have a couple of issues with mouth noise, especially lip smacks and soft palate clicks at the back here. So I need to get rid of those quickly if they do appear. And for that, I use spectral editing tools by MPL. I'll put the link in the description. All I have to do is hit O to open the tool, select the audio I want to edit, hit I to add the edit and change the parameters to suit whatever it is I'm editing. I don't use it a lot, but when I do, it is invaluable. Finally, I often have to record several takes of the same word or the same line, and I need a way to be able to quickly split and trim those, as well as arrange them so they have the same interval between them. Special thanks go to the Homebrew Audio channel for really helping out with this one. I just select the audio to trim, hit A to bring up the audio trim split menu. I already have this set up to my liking, and I hit process. It's not perfect, but it saves a ton of time. I then hit Q to bring up the reposition items menu. Don't forget you can change all these keyboard shortcuts in the actions menu. I make sure it's set to item end. I set the time and then hit OK. And we are done. And with all that in place, let's talk about the actual workflow I use every day. Now, I sometimes have to do auditions or recordings very quickly, so I wanted to be able to open Reaper and do everything without thinking too much and with as few clicks and keyboard strokes as possible. And it happens like this. One, I open Reaper and the dialogue pops up, so I have to give the project a name. It's now saved. My microphone is always plugged into the interface with the gain at 3 o'clock, ready to go, so I can just hit 2 straight away to start recording. Hitting number 2 makes sense in my head. You use whatever makes sense in your head. Once I've finished recording, I make sure the levels are good and edit the recording if necessary. I can then trim and space the clips if I need to. I create a region by selecting the audio, hitting E for time selection, R for create region, and the dialogue pops open, and then I name the region. I then render that region by right-clicking on the region and selecting render region. Now I have everything set up in the render dialogue how I want it for my most popular render format, which for me is MP3 at 48 kilohertz, mono with a bit rate of 192 kilobits per second. Hit render, and we're done here and on to the glamour shots. But Reaper has one more trick up its sleeve. Yeah, Reaper is also a video editor. I mean, it's not going to put DaVinci Resolve out of business anytime soon, but it's absolutely perfect for doing one thing that I need it to do, synchronizing audio to video. Now, I'm sure there are AI tools out there that can do this, but if you want it done perfectly and properly, you need a human to do this. This is how I sync up for lip sync dubbing. First thing, import a video to a new track, then use the waveform to mark up where the voice to be dubbed is. I record my dub, I line it up with the video, make sure that the lip movements match the sound, because that's the whole point, and export it as the length of the video, and then the audio will match up perfectly every time. All of that is what I love about Reaper. Should you buy it? Well, that's up to you, but you should definitely try it out for 60 days, if nothing else. I mean, it's not flashy, it's not cool, it's a bit nerdy, to be honest, but it's yours if you're willing to take the effort to set it up so it works for you. And it does what it does with passion. And that's what I love about Reaper. It's no-nonsense ability to deliver your best work. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe if you want to as well. I'm Richard, and I am your voice actor. And because you made it this far, you might like these videos. Check them out.